start with the 29th example, and what is said here? A particle A having a charge of 2 into 10 raised to minus 6 coulomb is held fixed on a horizontal table. Okay, so this particular charge is fixed. A second charge particle of mass 80 grams stays in equilibrium on the table at a distance 10 centimeter from the first charge. So let us say that's the table and this is the charge 1. Okay, 2 into 10 raised to minus 6 coulomb, and this particular charge is fixed on the table on this surface, while the another second charge particle of mass 80 grams stays in equilibrium. Here there is a second charge particle. Say this is the first charge particle, this is charge number particle number 2, and the separation between them is 10 centimeter. The coefficient of friction between the table and the second particle is 0.2. Here the friction is 0.2 coefficient of friction. Find the range within which the charge of this second particle may lie. Okay, so in what range this is lying? So no problem. So first of all, as we can say, both the particles, let us say if they are equally charged. So if they are equally charged, so particle 1 will try to repel particle 2 by this force q2 upon r square. But friction between table and this particle will not allow this. Okay, so suppose I am calculating the maximum value of this charge, so the friction will also be the limiting friction. Okay, so what could be the range so that it will not move? So the condition is that the electrostatic force of attraction or repulsion, I have shown repulsion, q by r square, must not be greater than the limiting friction or maximum value of static friction. It should be less than or equal to static friction, and I will get the value of charge range, that is from 0 to this value. So therefore the charge range required will be equal to the static frictional force, is nothing but mu into n, while here the action is mg, so the reaction on the force is also mg, so it will be mu s into mg. So it will be mu s into mg into, this will go there, 10 into 10 raised to minus 2 will be 10 raised to minus 1, and square will be 10 raised to minus 2 divided by k, 9 into 10 to the power 9 into 2 into 10 to the power minus 6. Okay, so I can say the charge must be at least less than or equal to, so mu s, which is 0.2, m, which is 80. In order to convert gram into kilogram, 10 raised to minus 3, the value of g, I am taking 10, into 10 raised to minus 2, whole upon 9 into 10 raised to 9 into 2 into 10 raised to minus 6. 2 1s are 0.1. 9 1s are 9 9s are 81. So approximately I will, 9 9s are 81. So this is 80. So approximately that can be easily taken. So the charge must be less than or equal to. So this is the only number here, 9, while others are the power of 10. So this is 10 raised to minus 1, this is 10 raised to minus 3, this is 10 raised to minus 2, this is 10, so it will be plus 1. This will come up, so it becomes plus 6, this will come up, it becomes minus 9, so let's add them. Minus 3, minus 1, minus 3, minus 4, minus 4, minus 2, minus 6 plus 1, 5, minus 5, minus 5 plus 6, plus 1, minus 9, minus 8. So finally the power comes out to be 10 raised to minus 8 coulomb. So the range of charge must be 0 to this. Okay. So the either charge is 0 plus or minus 0 to plus or minus 9 into 10 raised to minus 9 coulomb. That must be the range of this charge so that it will not move. Thank you.